Manufactured Home Sales Mastery is not a company. It is a movement. Really take the time and think of what else is going right. Because if you're not grateful for those things, you could go into a downward spiral and start hitting a rut. Who you are right now has gotten you to where you're at. But if you're truly going to take this to the next level, then you need to grow. All right. Welcome to the Zone of Enrichment, the room of constant, never-ending improvement. This is Kaizen, and this is the Manufactured to Win podcast. Coming back at you, we're in San Antonio this week. We're back home. We've been in San Antonio this whole week, getting prepared for the next 4 weeks. Actually, I think it's 5 weeks of just back-to-back-to-back travels, which is exciting. It's exciting, but you know, still got to handle stuff because you still got life going on, right? I've got kids going back to school on Monday. Today's Friday. And so handling that and just preparing for all these things, it's been an adventure. But anyway, that's Jackson.
What's up, y'all?
I'm Suzanne, as you guys know. And, you know, we're coming in today because we wanted to talk over a few things. Sometimes it gets lost on folks that they think, man, these guys, they're traveling, right? They're building a business. They're doing these things. And I try and make it very, very transparent in what we put out there. You know, now that you're helping out with the videos and everything that we do, it's just a whole lot better quality, obviously. But, you know, I want to portray or let people know that the real side of building the business, right? And so I've never been one to shy away that from time to times, we run into problems. We run into issues, right? Things don't work out the way that you've got them planned. And whether you're building a business or whether you're out there selling manufactured homes or whatever it is that you're doing, there's always going to be issues. There's always going to be problems that come up. But it's how we respond and how we react that's going to make all the difference in the world, right? And I know that you've seen different people react different ways, when, you know, you yourself, right, when you've had things that go on. But like this week was truly an ass whip for me. Because, man, I wanted to get everything wrapped up with the new office that we're trying to get moved into, and we just weren't able to get everything lined up the way we wanted to. So now, which maybe is a blessing since we're going to be traveling, you know, for the next few weeks. But still, you know, you want to have these things out of the way, moved out of the way. But it seems like we're finally coming to a wrap on that. They're going to get the stuff done so we can get moved in and continue growing. But, you know, what I'm wondering, Jackson, is what have you seen? Now, like, this has been, I think, our first full week home without traveling since you've been a part of this, right? What has that felt like to you?
Honestly, it's felt a little weird. Like, I don't know, traveling, it kind of keeps you on your heels and kind of keeps you going on schedule. And then when you're on home, you're like, well, I'm at home, so I'm just going to work from the couch or, you know, do all this. So I think it's been a struggle, probably.
It is. It is a struggle to get used to. And, you know, it's the same thing that you probably go through. I know that you go through because I've done what you've done, being out there, whether it's a retail center or a community, and selling homes. You've got those times where you just feel like you're not getting anything done, and you are getting stuff done. I really, when you start to think, if I'm honest with myself, I have gotten stuff done. You've gotten some stuff done on the videos that we've been working on and things of that nature. But you just want things to go exactly the way you have them planned, right? But when it doesn't happen that way, it really can throw you off, and you feel like you're not accomplishing those things. And so, how would you describe it when now that you said, yeah, I mean, sometimes feel like you're just twiddling your thumbs, right? But you're really not. But what runs through your mind when you're sitting there and you're second guessing yourself? Or are you even second? Because I know I am. If I feel like I'm not getting something done or something doesn't work out the way that I thought it was going to, I start to wonder, did I screw that up? Did I mess up? Right? What do you think?
I kind of just look for like a physical sign. Like if I don't think I'm getting anything done, I'll look back to like the day's work and the drive that I post and count, you know, okay, I've done, you know, 15 videos, 15 edits, you know, that's good, you know, and then kind of pace myself and kind of just seeing those physical signs. Because if I try to look and just wander off and
yeah,
count in my mind something that I've done, it won't work out.
Yeah, and that's true. You that's why I say you got to look, you got to be honest with yourself and look at what have you accomplished, right? What have you actually gotten done throughout the week? Now, at the same time, you don't want to fool yourself, right? Could there have been more stuff done? Probably. There should have been more things done. And it's always about progress. We're talking about progress. You need to be making progress all the time. And so if I'm being sincere with it, you know, there are some great things that happened this week as well, right? And obviously on the personal side with the two younger ones going back to school, right? Yeah. They're going to start school on Monday. So getting all that out of the way, you know, soccer practice started again this week. Things are moving the way they should be, but inside just kind of like feel restless for some reason. And the reason I bring that up is because, like I said, if it happens to me and it's happening to you, it happens to everybody. So how we respond, again, is so important. And these things happen. And because the manufactured home world goes so fast, this business, even though it takes a while for the deal to get done, the sales cycle is a longer sales cycle, it's still a fast-moving business. And you can feel as though you get lost in it and don't understand if you are or are not making progress. Sometimes you start to doubt yourself, but you've got to really take the time and think of what else is going right. Because if you're not grateful for those things, you could go into a downward spiral and you start hitting a rut. Okay. And you haven't experienced these things. You haven't seen these happen within the business, but believe me, it happens. You know, you can get in a rut where 1 week turns into two bad weeks, turns into a month. And these ladies and gentlemen out there are wondering how the heck they're even going to get themselves out of it. So it's about being grateful for the things that have gone right. Be honest with yourself and realize, okay, what could I have done different? It's focusing on what you control that makes all the difference in the world, right? And so when I stop to think about it, I think, well, you know what? We actually picked up a new contract. We got things worked out for the show that we're going to be at in Atlanta, right? That week of September, got that thing hashed out. We actually had some people reach out to us that want to be a part of the company, you know, not just Justin, but a couple of others. And that right there goes to show that as long as you're doing the right thing, people are going to notice. People are going to notice if you're doing right by others and taking care of them. And when they see that, people get inspired. People get inspired by that. And people want to be inspired. And that's the whole reason for this show today, really. It's about one of the things that I realized, man, this was last night, right? 4 a.m., friggin' smoke alarm goes off in the house. Okay. Smoke alarm goes off in the house because we've got a genius son, our 11-year-old, love him to death, right? Christian, you're watching this. Yes, we're talking about you. Decides he's up in the middle of the night because there's a new release coming out to Fortnite, which I don't agree with, but whatever, right? But anyways, he's up. He decides to light a candle and the freaking candle sets off the smoke alarm. So I wake up, can't go back to sleep. And I started thinking about those things. The people that have been, the people that have reached out to us that want to be a part of this. What we've really done, even over the last few weeks in helping people, you know, seeing their response. Yesterday we had that training call, the Zoom training call for the ELS group. And, you know, you've got 50, 60 people on the Zoom call at a time. And then people emailing afterwards, that not only happened last week, happened this week as well, where they'll email afterwards and really appreciative for the information and the help that we're giving them. And it just fills you up. It fills you up with gratitude and it makes the struggle all worth it. And it also made me realize that what we're building here is not a company. And that's what I wanted to come and talk to everybody about. Manufactured Home Sales Mastery is not a company. It is a movement. It is a movement of taking this industry and turning it on its heels. And some people, it rubs the wrong way when I tell them that, right? When I start saying, hey, man, we're here to revolutionize the industry. They're like, this cocky son of a... But it's the truth. It's the truth. It's a movement. Because we want to see everyone benefit. Will everybody benefit? I'm realist. I understand not everybody's going to take it and not everybody's going to run with it. Not everybody makes the decisions, right, to actually put those things into practice. But the ones that do make a huge difference. And the ones that do see the difference. And they not only see the difference in their business, they see the difference in their life. And now that we're 16 months into this, so we've had some traction. We've had some people that we've been working with for a while, 6-7 months consistently. And to see their growth, to see what's going on, and to see the impact it's made in their life. And it's amazing to see. And that's where last night I got to thinking, this is truly a movement. And what we've done up until now has gotten us to the point where we're at. You know, you're not only a part of the company, right? You're actually a part of our family. So you've seen the struggles part of it as well at the beginning, right? And so you know that we're at a different spot now and things are a little bit better, right? They're not fully 100%, but they're a little bit better. But I was realizing last night, even for myself, and I shared this with the team from Mobile Home Masters this morning when I was on their sales meeting, on their sales call. Who we are right now, folks, myself included, when I was talking to them, who we are right now got you to where you're at right now. Whatever point in life you're at right now, you, Jackson, where you're at and what you're doing, who you are right now has gotten you to where you're at. Those of you watching right now, wherever you're at in your business, who you are has gotten you to where you're at. And if I'm going to grow this movement and take it to that next level where now I have people that want to, that are reaching out to us, I'm not reaching out to them. They've reached out to us because they want to be a part of this. They want to help other people. I realize that I need to grow. Right. And so I was having that conversation at 4:30 in the morning. and I realized, you know, I think I'm a pretty good leader. I think I'm pretty well versed, and you probably feel the same way about yourself out there. You think, you know what? I'm pretty good at what I do. I'm a great person. It's undeniable that a lot of you out there are probably even better than me. But if you're truly going to take this to the next level, then you need to grow. If you wanted to take your production company and you want to go that next level in filmmaking and things of that nature, you're going to have to grow beyond who you are right now. Right? And the same thing goes for you guys. So when I was thinking about this, I thought, who I am right now has gotten me. And that's that I've continued learning every day, even as while building this company or this movement, right? It's going to be called a movement from here on out. I've continued learning and growing, learning new things, but it's gotten me to where I'm at. But now to lead other people and build this thing to that, where that next level, it's going to take me growing as a leader, me growing, not just in my skills to be able to work with you folks out there, and to teach someone else to do what I'm doing as well, and the reason we do it and how we do it and things of that nature. But it's about leading people, because something made them want to reach out to me. Something they saw, something they've noticed, whether it's that they noticed us working with these great folks out there or whatever it is, something made them. Now I have that responsibility to not only live up to that, but then help them get to that point, right? And you need to be thinking about that as well for yourself. Like, okay, how do I get there, and who are the people that are going to come with me? And the reason I bring this up is because for you out there, whether you're a retailer, community, you're a community manager, or a professional housing consultant, you are leading these people. And you truly are their movement. They need these homes. They've got a reason for it. Even those people I talk about all the time, the people that are buying these homes as maybe secondary houses or vacation homes, they're still needing you to accomplish that for them. And you need to continue to grow. And you need to continue to improve. We have never arrived. That's the thing. I've known that all along. Like, you never truly arrive, right? They say you never really truly get to a stopping point if you're thinking about growing and building something big. But last night or early this morning, it hit me. Like, I'm never truly going to get there. There's a new version of me. And there should be a new version of you. And there should be a new version of you all the time, getting better, constantly improving. Kaizen, right? Continuous improvement. I saw a post on LinkedIn today, this morning. And it was just so appropriate that I saw it this morning after I had this epiphany. And it's from Brian Benstock. And if you guys don't know, we'll put a clip. I'm going to send you the thing so you can post it on there. But he had he's a partner in a Honda dealership up in New York State somewhere. Very, very well-educated guy. Started in sales and now is a partner in this deal. And has done a lot of great things. But anyway, he was talking about that. How salespeople, all right? We're all salespeople, man. Everyone is a salesperson. Everybody. Even you. You got to sell people on moving forward with doing things, you know, within the films and things of that nature. Great salespeople never stop learning, never stop improving. They don't just practice on the day. You shouldn't just be practicing when you're in front of your customers, right? You shouldn't just be practicing when you're on set. It's the preparation you put in before that makes all the difference in the world. And that's where I love at the end, he writes about the people that invest the time. The people that invest the time into their growth get paid their unfair share. And I thought that was huge. You can get paid your unfair share in this business. You guys know the type of money that's available to you out there. Some of you, most of you probably already experienced it, right? And I'm not talking ditto hundreds. I'm talking there's guys in this business on the sales floor that make $200,000, $300,000, $500,000. I've known them. It's out there. You can do that. Just depending on your role, depending on compensation plans, right? That's my disclaimer. But he describes it as an unfair share. And I thought that was very interesting that he used unfair, because most people will think that you, let's say as you grow your production company, right? And you start being more and more successful. And you maybe start making bank more than your friends who go to school, right? That continued on with their education and whatnot. And you get to that point, they're going to say it's unfair. It's not fair that you make that much money. They say it to, they would say it to us. I mean, I know they say it to you on sales floor, right? Why should a salesperson make that much money? Why shouldn't they? They're putting in the work. They're doing those things. They're helping people out. And those of you that invest the time to get better will make more than the ones that don't. And the only people are going to say that are that it's unfair are the people that aren't willing to put in the work to get better. Right? And we're just a little piece of that you getting better. We're just a little piece of you improving. Whether we come to you and do a training class or you're logging into our training online, whatever it may be, maybe you decide to be a part of our coaching system on your own, not waiting for your company to do it, and you take the initiative. We're just a small piece of it. You have to continue on your own, growing and learning and improving each and every day. Do you feel, Jackson, that right now you are at the same place you were even a year ago in your knowledge of what you do?
Definitely not.
Okay.
Definitely have grown.
Why? How?
I think just look, I mean, I could see it physically in terms of watching Escape the Ocean, the film I put out last year, and then watching the first cut of my finished movie that I did this summer in terms of, you know, the color, in terms of the shots and the knowledge that you need to be a, you know, be a better filmmaker. It's definitely grown. And yeah, I look back at Escape the Ocean and I'm like, what were you doing?
Yeah. So you can see how you've improved, you know, your vision's improved. And I'm not talking about your vision behind the camera, just you, your whole idea of things, it grows. And that's just because you continue to get better. But when we don't grow, folks, is when we're not getting better, when we're not pushing ourselves, when you're just there and you're letting stuff, you're letting every day just go and happen. That's when you feel you're not accomplishing anything. That's when you feel you're not any better than you were before. So you don't put in any extra effort then, and you don't put any extra effort after that. And you feel that you're going backwards. And you know why you feel you're going backwards? Because you are. You're going backwards. You're going backwards. And even if you stayed at some people, here's the thing, Jackson. Some people reach a certain point, right? And they say, hey man, I'm making 100 grand, and that's great. And I'm throwing that number out there arbitrarily. Okay. I know not everybody does. But let's just say you've got somebody who started in the business. And prior to them being in this business, maybe the most they made was $40,000, $50,000, $60,000, right? And they make $100,000, and then they stay stuck there for the rest of their life, 100, 115, 120, maybe 1 year is 95, but they're in that area. And if you stay there, maybe you're okay, you're taking care of your things, but here's the issue with that. There's always people passing. There's always people that are going to do more and better. So you may think, hey man, I'm still good. I'm doing the same. But you're actually going backwards. But you're going backwards because everybody's passing you up. So it's not good to stay in the same spot. I don't care if you've been doing this 5 years, 20 years, 40 years. That's why you should be even that much more ahead and pushing yourself when you've been at something for that long.
Kind of like when you were showing Sebastian, when you told him, where you guys were downstairs and you and Christian were putting in the work and he was staying behind. And
Yeah, I mean, it's so our two younger boys, they play soccer, both of them. And the youngest, who's always been an animal, he's been a beast. For some reason, this last month, he's just been slacking off. Big time. I mean, big time. Sebastian, you've been slacking off, right? He's 7 years old. But anyway, and so I used that example. You're right. I used that example. I said, look, you think you're good, but you're right here. And everybody else keeps putting in the work and they just get better than you. And even though you're at a good spot, you're still behind because everybody passed you in skill. Everybody passed you in knowledge. Everybody passed you in income. And I'm talking to you guys right now that are watching this, that are out there selling these homes, helping folks out. You reach that point and you think you're good and you stay right there, but everybody's passing you. So you're actually going backwards. Don't let yourself go backwards. Believe me, there's going to be plenty of time for you to just stay where you're at. And that's when they bury you. You're not going to go anywhere. You're going to be right there. All right. But up until then, and that may be, you know, you may think like, why is he even saying that? But it's the truth, right? Let's just be honest. But up until that point comes, you should always be moving forward, always be trying to improve. You know, during the Olympics, there was a commercial that was coming out a lot with this lady who does track and field. I think she's like in her 90s. And she's still doing track and field. I don't know if anybody ever, if y'all saw that during the Olympics or you're watching, but there's a lady who does track and field. So I think she's like 93. And she's out there running. I mean, obviously, she's not going to keep up with these girls, right? But she's running track and sprints, you know? And she's 93. I mean, I can only hope that I can run like that when I'm 93. You know, and that's the whole thing, and that you just have to keep moving in that direction. And that's why with us here at Manufactured Home Sales Mastery, it's all of us moving forward. And that's the conversation I had this morning, is if I thought that I put in the work so far, it's going to be even more now with these people coming on board, because we're at that place, man. We're at that place where it can go one way or the other. And if we do this thing just right, it's just going to skyrocket. And just like with you guys, think about it this way. If you're at that point, you're making I use that number arbitrarily. If you're making $100,000, and if you go from making $100,000 to making $300,000, why are you going to make $300,000? The only reason you're going to make $300,000 is because you're helping more people. Plain and simple, right? The only way you're going to make more money is if you're adding more value, or if it's through a film, is because the film's just that much better than the other one, right? So the only reason people get paid more is because they're worth more or they're doing more. So don't feel bad if you go from this point to that point, because all that means for you out there in manufactured home sales is that you're helping more people. So if we take this company and take it from where it's at right now and make it a multi-million dollar movement, right? It's not a company, it's a movement. It's because we're helping more people. We're helping more people improve. We're helping more people help more people. Everybody wins. And that's the beautiful thing about what we're doing here. And I'm super excited. And at the same time, I'm scared, man. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not scared in the I'm not gonna do it scared. But it's a little overwhelming. It's a big responsibility. And I knew it was going to come. But back then, I was just trying to survive, right? Trying to build it. But now that we're here, now it's like, oh, crap. Now what? Yeah. Now it's right here. Now it's put up or shut up, right? Now it's put up or shut up. And it's exciting just because that's the way I'm, man. I'm, you know, that I'm a roll of dice, and if we fall, we fall, but we're going to do everything we in our power to make it happen. And that's what we want you to do. Everything in your power to make it happen. Put in the work, go after it, because what you do affects so many people's lives. And we are honored to be a part of it, right? And so if you're going to be anywhere in these places, right, as we wrap up, if you're in Denver, we're going to be in Denver next week.
I'll put a like a
there you go. Schedule. Yeah, we'll put it off here. But Denver, Tampa, we're going to be in Tampa for the whole week. We're doing our immersion sales training. You guys have been hearing more and more about the empowering community managers. In Tampa, we're doing our immersion sales training, which is a full week long for brand new housing consultants. It's 5 days of just immersion, full intense training that we're going to be doing. But we'll be in Tampa the week after that. Then we go to Phoenix. And then we'll be in Tyler. I'll be in Tyler. You'll be on the road. And then the week after that, we're in Atlanta. So if you're in any of those spots, it'll be on the screen. Hit us up. We'd love to meet you guys and just see what we can do to help. But other than that, you guys go out there, make the most of the opportunity each and every day. Because, like I said, at one point in time, you won't be able to do it. Keep that in mind. It's not being morbid. It's just being real. You guys go out, crush it, man. And as always, can't meet you. Wait. I'm not gonna mess it up. And as always, we can't wait to meet you. Let's go, baby.